the 1960s, my generation set out on a journey of change. Coming out of an atmosphere of conformity, a new spirit began to appear. One of the first signs was a demonstration organized by Berkeley students in May of 1960 against the House Un-American Activities Committee.
What we are here to do is to gather information, as we are ordered to do by an act of Congress, with respect to the general operation of the communist conspiracy.
I'm not in the habit of being intimidated, and I don't expect to start now. Now, what was your question?
Please, Mr. Chairman.
What was your question?
Are you now, this instant, a member of the Communist Party?
We came out to protest because we were against HUAC's suppression of political freedom. In the 50s, HUAC created a climate of fear by putting people on trial for their political beliefs. Any views left of center were labeled subversive. We refused to go back to McCarthyism.
If you think that I am going to cooperate with this collection of Judases, of men who sit there in violation of the United States Constitution, if you think I'll cooperate with you in any way, you are insane.
As witness after witness denounced the committee, the hearings grew stormy. The halls outside were filled with students seeking admission. Suddenly, the police turned fire hoses full force on the demonstrators inside the rotunda and then dragged them down the steps of City Hall. It turned out to be a political baptism that transformed fear into determination. Something had changed. After this, it would never be the same.
There's a time when the operation of the machine becomes so odious, makes you so sick at heart, that you can't take part, you can't even passively take part, and you've got to put your bodies upon the gears and upon the wheels, upon the levers, upon all the apparatus, and you've got to make it stop, and you've got to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all.